Hello. Thank you everyone for your coming. And thank you, Jean-Pierre, for your recording. Today I want to introduce you something, the sweet thing, this will be future of television, of the management system. By this time, as we know, we have a lot of system that's working on television. First, everyone talking is the MAM system. Practically, MAM is not the only one system that's working on the television. Television is the moment. You can see MAM normally is work is with playout automation, with the studio automation, and in the bigger television, we also have the traffic system, have the billing system for all the advertisement is on the television station, and new department as the separate department. And also, we have also PAM system. This is the, sometimes is the combined with the MAM at the one system, but it's also is separate because is the subject of this is not ready program for playout. But the subject of this is the material for production, for no-liner editing. So it's the something before you got the ready material in MAM, you have the PAM system. So anything we have here is mentioned on the floor, so on the television station and in the broadcast market. But a lot of other things that we do not mention about this and do not have the any tool to manage it. But it is on the system and it is need to manage. It's the staff, that normally is the managed by outside program, written by the IT department or others. Company that is non-connected to that television, so there is normally staff is the not non-connected with the MAM system or other system that we have in the television station. The production script also is wasted at this moment because it's the MAM do not include the MAM that have the text option to include production script. All the other facilities of the television station also is not managed. It's the vehicle, it's the equipment, it's the facilities like studios, like different OB van. There is the non-management and we do not know where they are and what they do, what is planned for this product. And what more, we do not have the salary. This is highly connected to MAM also because the any product on the television station is the connected with salary. If the payment is depend on the production, the salary will be connected with MAM. And one thing more is production cost. So also it's connected with everything. It's connected with the MAM because it connected with PAM because how much the clip you recorded is the involved is production cost. What about the facility? Which facility you use? Studio time, equipment time, or vehicle, everything is connected to production cost. But you have nothing, all the information at this moment is lost. This means it's non-connected together. But in practically, it's theoretically everything is connected to media because we are media production. So the studio is using for production certain product in MAM or it's used for record some clip for the PAM system. The salary is paid for product is made and registered in MAM. And all the production script is for some product in the MAM. So everything is look like this. This everything is the is beyond MAM. This known at this moment is in television station we do not have any management of them. This is not enough. So it's MAM is not enough to cover the everyday station activities. This is why is the HD station is approaching. This is why we are trying to do all the thing connect together to the MAM to make a MAM and we join the MAM thing to make the whole TV station a paperless production system. And this is the idea. The idea is anything that's connected to production to the man must be managed. So the product itself, is you can trace back any product, you can trace back the production script, you can trace back what is the equipment it used, what the OB van it used, what the camera it used for the production, and who is take part in the production. Even the cameraman, which cameraman, how long he's worked on this project, and is how he share which producer is working on this project. This is finally is come to the MEM. So everything is covered by module. This is part of the joint MEM system. To make it available, if you can make it, you have the complete system. For the MEM is to cover the core of the television station only. But for DieuNguyen, the MEM, we start from idea. We record from idea and we cover all everything over the production line to get the media to record it on the MEM. So the system is to complete it and to make it available. To make it available, we must introduce something new, because it is you cannot make the standard business workflow. Standard workflow is for business. That means it's not for media. Here we have a media-centric system. We have media. You have the media-centric. So everything is run around the media. So we cannot use some workflow. Workflow is the people-centric system. Any workflow that we have on the media at this moment is the media-centric, people-centric. It means it say what people to do on the media system, but it is wrong. Since media is the main factor here, so everything is go around the media. It's not go around the people, but go around the media. So it will be a media-oriented. Media-oriented system is the more correct thinking, and this is the more. This is what we do. The standard workflow, you have the different job to do, and each job is in certain stage. So you have to finish the first stage to start the next one, and that is a standard workflow. The standard workflow is the non-useful in the on the new IT design. So the workflow, we change the workflow to the more modern one. This means it's everything you use the management system to connect all the part together. So you have everything, you have to go through this. So you can start here, you can start from anywhere, and it will work. So it is the there is no waiting time. So you have that you any element in the system can work in any time and to make it run. So return to the what we said is we have to change the idea on media flow on workflow. So we call it a media flow. Instead of workflow, we call it a media flow. This is new idea on television. This is the media centric. Instead of people-centric, this is the media-centric. The approach allow people to make a different, make a much more thing. This means it make the production easier. We can see the difference between the workflow and the media flow. In the case of workflow, you look in the system and systems tell you what you have to do. But in the media flow is different, because media flow is in the media. The media, on the media flow, media just have the instruction to do, what to do through the whole the line. And the workflow is only part of the media flow. I mean media flow here is it's like instruction to media, what to do. It starts from the each media on the system will follow some instruction. They will get exactly the long list instruction. What the media to do? What is the operation on the media? Or where it have to go? Or what is included in the media? Or where it have to go? And what is the operation is on the media is need to do? So instead of the workflow, this is only small part of the media flow. The media flow allow the system to make a flexible adjustment of the each process on the television station. Any process, because the workflow on the television is only one part of the whole media flow. So the system can be, thanks to the introduction of media flow, we can get the whole TV station as a paperless working business. The next thing that we try to the new idea that we bring to the system is the full 4K full editing. So we have the two method of implement the 4K editing. Normal 4K editing that we have, it actually we have the low res production. After low res, cut edit, we make a final edit, and final edit, we make the export. And here is on high res already. But in practical implementation, the editor don't like the workflow, because they have to think twice time. The first time they have to think on the project. The second time, again, they sitting on the high res and they're thinking again, the same thing. And this is make them boring and they don't like it. We find out that it is more efficient editing system is the everything you do on the low res. This means there will be full features editing on the low res. After the full editing on the low res, on the high res, you only make the export. Just export it. There is no more editing sitting on the export or the 4K product. So the workflow is to make the system, is make the feeling of the editor is much better. And it's only available thanks to the extension of the Adobe Premiere on the CC version. This means it's the newest version of the Adobe allow the system to be programmed and make this kind of editing. So you can make a full 4K editing, low res editing on the Adobe Premiere and transfer full the project to the 4K high res to produce it. You can do the editing manually, but this is very time consuming, because you need to do everything manually on the system. But in the case of using the management system, this IT station, you have everything you work. The only thing you work is the management system. So you work on low res and the system automatically export for you the high res for 4K. So as conclusion, we want to bring to the market the new three new ideas. So the first idea is the idea that MAM is not enough and we can do more for the management or television station to make it full, to make it completed, and everything that's connected to media will be managed on the one system only, module by module, step by step, but it have to be completed in one platform. That is what we do. And the second is the introduction of the media flow instead of the workflow. Media flow will be more flexible than workflow, and it's allowed the implementation of any management system on record time. Normally, for MAM system, we see it's very long time to introduce the one TV station. But in our case, normally we have only 1 or 2 weeks to implement the system, because most of the media flow is quite simple and quite clear, and similar to a lot of the group of staff. Not different. It's different from the on the workflow. Workflow is for people. On television station is so much people and so much the role of them. But media is type of media is not so much. And the, each media type have the different the workflow. And the workflow of media it make the media more much more simple to implement in the television station than the workflow. And the third one I have told you is the idea of the full features low res editing instead of the cut editing to make the system more efficient and make the editor more comfortable with the day working. Because they don't care with what is they working on 4K or HD or SD. They just work on the low res. After the low res, the system automatically generate the appropriate resolution. That's all. Thank you for your attention.